In this tutorial, we'll discuss how to edit a video recording in Panopto. We'll also cover adding chapters to facilitate navigation for longer videos. Within your course, choose the Panopto Recordings link in the menu at left. On your Panopto Recordings page, you'll see a list of your recordings. We need a Panopto recording at least a couple of minutes long to work with. So if you already have one in your Panopto recordings, choose that one. If you do not have a recording yet, or do not have one of sufficient length, pause and create one. Doesn't have to be fancy, just a couple of minutes of talking and or screen sharing. If you need a refresher on recording in Panopto, go back to the Getting Started with Panopto tutorial. Once you have a recording to work with, we can continue. If you move your cursor over a recording, you'll see buttons appear. Settings, Share, Edit, Stats, and Delete. Select Edit. At the top of the Edit screen, you'll see the course you're currently in and the video's title. You can edit your title here if you like. Further over, we have Undo and Redo buttons, a button to apply changes as we edit, and a button to revert back to the previous version. The gear icon allows us to change some advanced settings, and these bars show video view statistics. There's an exit option and a help button. At top left is our menu for all the types of edits we can make to our videos. Contents allows us to create a table of contents. With that, we can set points in the video where we cover certain topics and allow viewers to move immediately to that point. Table of contents will then show on the video and viewers can click to move to those set points within the video. We will come back to this feature later in the tutorial. Captions are automatically created when our video processes, but we do need to edit the captions for accuracy and for reasons of accessibility. No matter how clearly we speak, there will be errors in the auto captions, often improper names or discipline-specific terms. Captioning videos in Panopto for Canvas is a separate tutorial. The other options include slides, which lets us add a PowerPoint to the video file and then choose particular slides to place at specific points in the recording. This can be helpful for explanations and or later updates to a recording. Quizzes allows us to insert quiz questions into the video at any point. The quizzes can be scored or not, and we can even require students answer quiz questions to continue watching the video. Cuts we'll cover in this tutorial, and finally streams. Streams are the different sources that are recorded when you create a video. To the right of the screen, you'll see your video. Below it is the play button. Hit the arrow if you'd like to watch your recording. The 10 in the circle with the arrows moves the video 10 seconds forwards or backwards. The bar to the right shows where you are in the video, and the timer counts the time. You can use the timer as you review your recording to make notes of places you'd like to edit. If you use your mouse on the progress marker, you can click, hold, and drag it to different points in the recording. To the right of the bar is a volume control and a button to adjust play speed in case you'd like to speed up or slow down your playback. Finally, there is preview. This toggles the view between preview to see the changes and timeline where we edit. Below the play button row, you will see a scissors icon, which is one way to initiate a cut. Plus sign is used to add items into the video recording. Click on the plus sign to see all the things you can add, such as YouTube and web page inserts. Hover over the three dots and it says Set Preview Image. The preview image is the thumbnail image for your video. So when you look at all the videos on the Panopto Recordings page, the picture you see for each is the preview image. You can choose an image from somewhere in your recording or upload something entirely different. If you don't choose one here, the default one remains. This Preview Cuts checkbox shows us the edited video as we work on it. The Normalize Volume checkbox helps to keep volume consistent throughout the recording. The slider at far right lets us zoom in and out of the section below, which will help us make more exact cuts. The next section has video frames with another time bar above and a sound bar below. Essentially, the pictures are snapshots of the video at each of these times. The bar is labeled at left with initials. The labels indicate which stream is shown, P1 for primary, and if I record multiple streams in my video, we would see other bars with S1 for secondary and perhaps even S2 for a third stream. Now that we've toured the edit screen, let's make some changes to our video. I am going to show you cuts and adding a table of contents. We'll look at making cuts first. When we record, there are often bits we'd like to remove. Watch your video and make note of any points where there's a mistake or somewhere you used the wrong term or perhaps pause for longer than you'd like. As we move through the recording, a red line follows through the rows below. For this example, I want to remove a silent bit of my video so I can look at the sound bar and see where there was no talking. When I find a point where I want to cut, I click my mouse button on the red line, hold it down, drag it to where the cut should end, and release. The gray bar shows the edit. Go up to the video, start it before the cut, and watch the line move as the video plays. The moving line goes up to the gray bar, jumps across, and continues. In Panopto, the trimmed part remains, so if you change your mind, you can put it back. To do that, you can use the undo button or the click and drag technique to remove the gray bar. To be more precise in a larger cut, click, hold, and drag the tiniest bit where the cut should begin. This creates a narrow bar as a starting point. Now play the video and hit pause where you want the cut to end. Grab and drag the gray bar's line, and when you get close to the red line, the gray bar will snap to the red and fill the space. Decide you want that piece of it back? Use undo or just clear that cut and start again. I suggest you pause the tutorial here and play with making cuts and removing cuts. Use undo and redo whenever you like, and if you reach a point where you want to clear all the gray bars and start over, go to the top, choose revert, and hit OK. When you are ready to save your cuts, choose apply at the top, and the video will process again. Processing the video takes a little while depending on the length of your recording. Remember that this does not delete the gray areas where you've made cuts. You can still recover those bits if you change your mind. For assistance with more complicated video editing in Panopto, contact your instructional design partner. If you'd like to learn how to add a table of contents to your video, keep watching. In Panopto, the Contents option on the Edit page lets us add a table of contents so that a viewer can see labeled points for different topics within the recording. Adding a table of contents, especially in a longer recording, allows a viewer to navigate more easily. Adding a table of contents is entirely optional, but it is very helpful, especially in longer videos. In my demo video, I'm showing PowerPoint slides, so I'm going to use slide titles as the points I enter in contents. I click in the box and type in my first heading, executing, and hit enter on my keyboard. It places the label above the box and shows a start time of 000. Now, I'll enter the other three segments of my video in the same way, influencing, relating, and thinking. They all say 000, so now I need to set the times where each part begins. I'll move through my video and note the start times for each segment. Then I place my cursor over the line for the first label, and the three dots appear. When I click on that, it gives me the options Edit and Delete. I choose Edit and get a pop-up. This lets me enter the time to place a marker at the proper moment in the video. I enter the time and press Save. You'll notice that the order has changed. This will automatically adjust as I enter the other times. When I'm done editing my video and creating a table of contents, I will apply my changes. The video will process again. Here's what a table of contents looks like in a Panopto recording in your Canvas course. The up arrow at the bottom displays the chapters created. When I click on a chapter, the video advances to that point. After you've finished editing your video, we suggest you add closed captions to your videos to make them accessible for all viewers. The next tutorial in this series will show how to auto-caption and edit captions for accuracy. As always, if you have questions, need assistance, or are interested in advanced features in Panopto, contact your instructional design partner.